what's it been like around here the last couple of days since the news on Sunday?
So, I've had a head coaching change before in my career when Coach Harson left. It's never an easy thing. You know, whatever January is going to look like as far as a new hire, what staff stays around, what staff leaves, all that stuff's kind of tough to navigate for the guys that still have eligibility. It's not going to affect me nearly as much, but I definitely feel it for those guys. But like anything, I think this team's going to do the best we can to respond in a positive way, deal with the adversity, and just keep on moving forward. I trust Coach D. I trust the rest of the staff. I know they'll be able to put a solid game plan together, and we'll be able to go out and execute.
How does Spencer Danielson, head coach, make this offense better?
I don't have a tremendous idea on exactly what he's doing, but Coach Hamden is a stud. I have complete faith in him. I know Coach Keen and Coach Potter are going to dial up whatever we need in the run game. They have plenty of know-how, you know, with kind of the quarterback system, whatever that was looking like. That's, you know, those decisions are far above my pay grade. So I'm going to go out, and whoever's out there, good to go. I can rock with Taylen all day long. He's a tremendous athlete. I'm going to do everything I can to make sure he's comfortable. I know the O-line's going to do the same. And we're going to go out on Saturday versus a very athletic and talented Utah State front and just do what we do best.
You mentioned the last coaching change. I mean, that came at the end of the season. You guys were done with the year. Having two games left, just kind of how's that experience different?
It could be an opportunity to be a distraction if we let it, right? You know, at the end of, if it's after a season, you're coming back in January and you're working out, right? But we're still in the middle of all of this stuff. We have preparation we got to do. We have two more games for sure guaranteed, maybe more if we can keep figuring some things out. Ultimately though, it's just about keeping the guys in the locker room together, and it's been good. You know, the guys are like, hey, it is what it is. And just be here now. Be here right now. Be where your feet are. Let it ride. Figure all the other stuff later.
It sounds like Sunday afternoon, Sunday evening, all the guys were pretty much determined to put the focus back on finishing strong. So what do you guys have to do to just kind of not let this be a distraction?
Just keep football the main thing. Don't get into the social media or all the what-if stuff that's going on out there, right? There's plenty of time to go look at that stuff later. Get in the film room, study, figure out the opponent each week. We have Utah State up next. That's all we got to worry about right now, just one day at a time.
How good has this offensive line been this year, and should maybe people be talking about it more?
No, that's the thing about O-line is you're never going to get any of that outward praise, and we know that. That's what we signed up for the day we decided to be offensive linemen, right? And we're good with that, working in the shadows. When it comes to QB protection, that's not solely us, though. That's the tailbacks have done an amazing job. Whether that's George back there, Ashton back there, young guys like Breezy, T. Crow, like whoever it is, them being able to understand our communication and get their job done. Tight ends as well. Because there's sometimes where, you know, max pro, you got seven or eight guys and they're working, and there's only five linemen on the field. So there's two or three guys that aren't online. So that's a credit to the whole unit right there, just working as one.
What can you tell us about Cage Casey and just his growth over the season?
Cage on the surface is a very kind of quiet, mellow guy. Undoubtedly an incredible athlete though. Big frame, long, very strong. He's got great feet. And how he's progressed through the year, him and Roger both being younger guys, have played very, very well. You know, there hasn't been a ton of drop off. And then, you know, we've had Ethan rotate in a little bit with Cage at the left tackle, or have Ethan in kind of those 6-0 line sets. It's just, we've had probably really seven or eight guys that have played very, very well for this offensive line.
What do you think, him only being a redshirt freshman, what is Cage capable of?
The sky's the limit for him. I know my first start came my second year, so yeah, redshirt freshman year, against Portland State at right tackle. And that was because we were short on bodies at the time. So for him to be in a starting role throughout the whole season that early, as well as Roger, is awesome. You know, I wasn't a really established starting offensive lineman until my redshirt sophomore year, that 2020 season. So it's going to be on him to just not be comfortable with the progress that he's made. Make sure he continues to push himself in the offseason, get in the film room, keep asking Coach Keen, hey, what do I need to do to keep improving, and just stay diligent with those details.
What have you seen from Taylen all season, just the way he's handled this roller coaster, and how's he embracing, you know, kind of his role this week, kind of being the lone guy again?
Taylen's been super humble. Obviously, going from starting to then not starting or being in rotation, all that's kind of tough and can wear on a guy's mental. But I think he's done a good job of staying positive and just continue to be thankful for all the opportunities that he does get. And then, he's started many games before, so he's kind of back to what that role used to be like. And I know he's going to do all his due diligence in his prep and be ready to roll.
Tell us about C.J. Tiller, and obviously now he's QB2 for a while. So if he were to have to go in here, and I know he hasn't played the game yet, but what do you think of C.J. Tiller?
I love C.J. He's definitely a solid athlete, and then from the stuff that we've seen in some good-on-good reps, whether that was back in spring ball or back in fall camp, you know, he's definitely got a good ability. I mean, he wouldn't be here if he didn't have that ability, right? So it comes back to that competition piece. And when your name is called, right, we talked about bleed blue, next man up mentality, not having to drop off. It'll be on him to make sure he can execute, and I believe in him wholeheartedly.
Have you guys ever been so excited just to get back on the field after you guys go through something like this? Like, how just eager are you to get the game day?
So it's interesting because throughout a whole week, there's a lot of prep and a lot of stuff that you have to do just to feel ready, right? It's not like, oh, we can screw up all week and then just Saturday feel good and all of a sudden show up. So that's where, you know, being present in the moment, like, it's one of those cliche things, but it holds so much truth. Like, Monday, we have stuff we got to do for that specific day to be ready for the Tuesday practice. Tuesday afternoon, we got stuff to do to be ready for Wednesday practice, so on and so forth. Like, each day is preparation. And you know, up until a couple hours before the game on Saturday, we'll still have a small little walkthrough. Like, we're still prepping up until the last minute. So once we finally get to game day, we know we're confident in our preparation. We're ready to roll.
One more night, because I don't know the next time we're going to get you. I know there's two games to go, but, you know, we talk about guys like Roger and Cage. Are they ready to kind of carry? You're going to have to hand the torch off here before too long, you and Cade. Like, are they ready to carry the torch up front?
No doubt. And then we have, obviously, Roger and Cage have been talked about quite a bit, but Ben Dooley's a guy that's still got more eligibility. Same with Mason Randolph. Like, there's a solid core group of dudes in that room. And, yeah, of course, a couple more guys are going to have to develop this offseason to be ready to fill some shoes next year. But there's a really solid base within the O-line room right now.
I know you guys have practiced with, like, wet balls this week because it might be bad weather on Saturday. Center, what's the biggest difference if the weather's not good?
It's just making sure you got a good grip on it and understanding what that feels like, so it's not a surprise when that moment comes up. Center's one of those things where if you're starting to feel a little not confident in your grip on the ball and you start squeezing it too much, or you're letting go too early, like, start letting those things get into your head a little bit, then it can get you out of your rhythm. But if you feel it, you know, on a Tuesday practice, you're like, okay, that's what that's going to be like, then make a little adjustment on your grip, whatever it needs to be. Talk with the quarterback, hey, what's the flight of the ball looking like right now? Everything good? As long as you're checking in on that throughout the week, you'll come on Saturday and you'll be all right with it.
Ashton Gentry, just full of personality, energy. What's it like having him back at practice, and how's he looking?
It's always great having him at practice. He's definitely got an infectious smile, a little sense of humor, and he's an incredible athlete. You know, when he's back there at practice, he's not quite able to showcase what he does on Saturdays because we don't need him jumping over like scout team players like he does on Saturday. But, you know, he's an explosive guy, and get the ball in his hands, like, it makes our job easier. Same with George Helani. Like, he's done a good job. Obviously, he missed a lot of time this season, which was a bummer for him. But yeah, first came back in like 2.5, not quite 3 quarters, already had 96 yards on the ground. So they're both solid backs, and they'll be able to get the job done.
I can't remember if it was Bush or Spencer, but when they were talking about Ashton, like, said that he's working really hard to get back, and I think they said that if he were able to provide a big boost for the team. Do you feel like that would be the case if he can get back and play for you guys this year?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, just what he's done and how consistent he's been playing, like, that's just another little bit of insurance or a little bit of confidence that's added to the offensive group as a whole. I think our run game's been pretty solid this year. But he's just a guy on the sideline that definitely brings the juice and can lift some spirits in that sense, for sure.